Hey guys, this is quick yoga stretch number 5. We're just gonna start off warming up with just a few standing warrior poses, and then we're gonna be totally down on the mat, so this is gonna be a nice, really calming and relaxing stretch. So let's get to it.
It's so relaxing. My cat has been put to sleep in the background. Okay, so start my timer. I'm gonna do 3 sun salutations. So, arms up, arch back, hands in front of your feet, look at your knees, flat back, down, jump into plank, forward, chaturanga, tuck your feet, roll forward, upward dog, tuck your toes, hips up, downward dog, drop your feet to your hands, straighten legs, look at your knees. And reverse. 2 more. Arms up. Arch back. Hands in front of your feet. Look at your knees. Flat back. Hands down. Plank. Chaturanga. Tuck your feet. Roll forward. Upward dog. Tuck your toes. Hips up. Downward dog. Oh, stretch. Oh. Beat your hands. Straight legs. Look at your knees. Reverse. Oh. And one more. Oh. Arch back again. Hands in front of your feet. Look at your knees. Flat back. Plank. Push up. Tuck your feet, roll forward, upward dog, tuck your toes, hips up, downward dog, and your feet to your hands, straighten the legs, look at your knees, in reverse. Okay, now we gotta do a sun salutation because we're gonna do warrior 1 and 2. We're gonna stay in it. Do it on one side, and then switch, and do it on the other. Alright, arms up, arch if you can, if you want to. Hands in front of your feet, look at your knees. Flat back, hands down. Plank, chaturanga, elbows close to your body. Tuck your feet, roll forward, upward dog. Tuck your toes, hips up. Downward dog, and right leg up, between your hands, left foot goes out at a 45 degree angle, so I'm turning the wrong way, face forward, get your hips forward, bend the front. Right leg, 90 degree angle, 5 parallel to the ground. Make sure the back leg is straight. Arms up. From here, we'll go to warrior 2 in a minute. Stay on this side. Deep breath. Okay, now open out. So now you're going to adjust the back foot so the toes are pointing straight out. 90 degree angle from the right front foot away from you. Leg still stays straight. Front leg still trying to bend it at a 90 degree angle. 5 parallel to the ground. And now the arms are going out to your sides. Even everything out. And you want to gaze over the front arm, front leg. Turn it to lean. Try to get your arms even. I'm trying. should be burning.
All right, come out. Oh.
Oh. I'm going to get back in the plank.
Jeez. Oh, it hurts.
Okay. Plank. Chaturanga. Duck your feet. All forward, upward dog. Tuck your toe. Hips up. Downward dog. Now we gotta do the other side. So, left leg up. Or if you just do the left, now do the right. Swing it through. Foot between your hands. Right back foot down. 45
degree angle
from the front foot. And you wanna get the hips forward. And front leg bent, 90 degree angle, side parallel to the ground, and the arms, face forward, hold. This side is a lot harder for me, back leg, keep it straight, no bend in the knee, bend only the front leg, front knee. Now, I'm going to be pointing straight out away from you. Leg still straight, not bent. Front leg, again, still 90 degree angle, parallel to the ground. Arms out to the sides. Front arm. This already really burns. Just checking myself to see my form, okay. Oh, I wanna hold it. Okay. Oh. I'm gonna get back in the plank. This is gonna be our last sun salutation. And we're just gonna stay down and stretch. Plank, tuck your feet, roll forward, upward dog, tuck your toes, hips up, downward dog, and tuck your feet to your hands, straighten the legs, look at your knees, reverse, okay, now we're going to just be down on the mat. And do a couple stretches. So, heron, sit your left leg out straight in front of you. Grab the right wrist with your left hand, your left fingers rather, your middle and thumb. And get it around the right ankle. The knee straight, flex the foot, pull the leg as close as you can towards you, keeping the left leg down on the ground, and just breathe. The worst is over. Now we're just stretching. Deep breath. Alright, and switch legs. So now the right leg goes out straight. Left leg is going to go up. And now you're going to grab the left wrist with the right thumb and middle finger behind the ankle. And straighten the leg, straighten the knee. Pull towards you. Flex the foot. the right foot and leg down in front of you. That foot, right foot flexed as well. So you're engaging everything. Just breathe into it. One more deep breath. Now get on all fours, on your hands and knees. We're just gonna do tiger. So make sure your hands, wrists are underneath your shoulders, knees under your hips. And you're gonna extend leg up to the sky as high as you can. And you don't have to hold this forever, just as long as you can. Okay. And you do it on the other side. If you can't get your leg up as high, that's totally fine. If you can get it higher, awesome. Whatever works for you, I'm just going as far as I can. You go as far as you can. So now, my leg up. Look up. And just hold. On your back, we're going to do bridge and one-legged bridge. If you want to try that, I think it feels really nice. It's up to you. So lay on your back, bring your feet close to your butt, and if you want to just stay here, you just push up and you can just hold this, hold it right here. If you want to go further, you can put your clasp your hands underneath you and walk your arms underneath your shoulders. And press up more, press up higher. If you want to do more, you can get your hands pressed underneath your sacrum, your lower back, just above your butt. Support. And now, if you want to, you can raise arm up. Your arms will totally hold you here. You should be completely stable. And just hold it up straight. Bring it down. And then you can just go back holding right here. And then switch other leg. Feel any pressure on your neck, don't do this. It should be all in your shoulders. Arms, never the neck. Always make sure you're tucking your chin to your chest and not directly pressing or leaning on your neck. Bring the foot down. And again, you can let the arms out and just clasp them underneath you again. Come back, hold them. Arms out. Hold. Keep holding, tightening the glutes. And power down. And now, just gonna do plow. So you wanna roll back, roll your feet over your head, toes on the ground behind you. If you need to come in
so to get your back ready. Do that.
The practice has helped. Practice so far has helped me open up enough that I can just get right into this. I hope it helped you too.
And now, we're just gonna do seated forward bend. So just make sure your back is straight and you're not rounding to go forward. You keep a straight back and you're laying your chest as far down, close to your knees as you can. You're just really trying to lengthen everything. You're not trying to just collapse on yourself. But you try to lengthen and pull everything close together. Oh. And you can hold your feet, or you can put your hands next to your feet. And as you sink, you can kind of stretch your fingers, slide them further away from you on the floor, and get deeper with each breath. I really like doing it this way.
Really helps you get deep.
All right, and now I'm just gonna finish with long spinal twist. So. Cat's looking at me like I'm crazy. Bring the right knee into your chest, over to the left, right arm out to the right, and press the knee into the ground and the shoulder into the ground. Look to the right, twist through both. This feels so good. This should feel really good. Work on getting your shoulder down and your knee down. Twist. Back to center. And right knee out, or right leg out straight. Left knee into the chest, over to the right. Left arm out to the left. Look to the left. Hold the knee down. Twist through the left shoulder and then the left knee. Twist through both. Keep both on the ground. Or try to get both on the ground. That's what you're working for. Twist through both. If I don't really activate, then my shoulder doesn't quite come up, but it doesn't press as firmly into the ground. So if you can see the difference, now I'm going to twist more into the shoulder. You see it go down? You might not be able to. I can feel the difference though. Alright. Back to center. And we're done. And it took, 19 minutes. So, this was a little bit longer than usual, but I think it felt so nice and relaxing. I hope it wasn't too challenging for you. I hope it was just the right length and that it felt really good. Hope you got a nice stretch in. Let me know. Let me know how you liked it. I wanted to keep it more basic and just relaxing and just to get a good stretch in without being too challenging today. So let me know. Leave me a comment. Like, subscribe, and share. And visit JiggityJack.com for the full workout breakdown and for fitness, nutrition, health, recipes. So much good stuff over there. So many more workouts and yoga routines and just everything. And if you're on Patreon, become a patron for as little as $1 a month so I can keep making more and more and more of these videos for you. And anything more that you want, let me know and we can make that happen. All right, thanks guys.